Hey everyone, Mr. Happy here, and in this video, we're going to be going over the changes coming to Paladin in Final Fantasy XIV's next expansion, Stormblood. Now, the footage you're seeing here is actually footage of me playing 4.0's Paladin, although just hitting a training dummy, from my recent trip to the North American Media Tour for Stormblood. So, I got to mess around with it a little bit, just a little bit of footage here of me hitting the dummy, but we're going to go over all the changes, even if they're not apparently evident from the footage. Keep in mind that all numerical values, animations, pretty much everything you see or hear here is still subject to change, so by June 16th, things may be different, but we'll see. Now, as a couple of reminders, some gameplay updates people might not be aware about, the parry stat is now gone. It's been replaced with Tenacity for tanks, which increases damage done and decreases damage taken. Now, keep in mind that that's just on gear that parry has been removed. Parry as a function is still in the game, as is blocking. Both of these things just occur at a flat rate as opposed to you being able to enhance them with gear. You can only enhance them through abilities. Speaking of blocking, by the way, big update to Paladin, blocking now works on magical attacks. This was a huge change that Paladin needed because the whole idea of blocking was really moot when you considered how many bosses had magical tank busters or magical auto attacks. It just made the shield feel like a lump of steel that was doing absolutely nothing, so I think that that is a very much needed change. Now let's go over some of their abilities that you might be familiar with already. We'll have to talk about a few changes here and there to existing abilities, but let's go through that first. So the Rage of Halone combo is still the same, but the strength reduction part of Rage of Halone is gone. Keep in mind that all the like int reductions and strength reductions that like Dragon Kick and Dark Knight had, those are all gone too, so it's just removed from weapon skills in general. Flash is still exactly the same, no it doesn't deal any damage. Goring Blade combo is the same. Now Royal Authority is still there, but it no longer combos off Savage Blade, it instead combos off Riot Blade, which when you're going out to do some DPS, it's definitely going to be more advantageous for it to be there, especially because you're going to get a little bit more MP, which will matter when we talk about a few things later. Shield Lob is still there, Shield Bash is still there, Shield Swipe is still there, Shield Oath and Sword Oath, of course, are still there. Big news though for those of you upcoming Paladin, Shield Oath is now level 30. This was a major quality of life thing, was just so annoying about Paladin compared to the other two tanks when new players were leveling it up, is that they wouldn't get Shield Oath to level 40. It didn't make any sense. Now, you'll get Shield Oath at level 30, and you get Sword Oath at 35. Let's see, Sentinel's still there, Fight or Flight is still there, Clemency is still there, but Paladin got a new trait that prevents any spellcasting from being interrupted at higher levels. I believe they had worked that into Clemency before the expansion, but they do have another spell they can cast now, so it'll affect both of them. Divine Veil is still there, Sheltron is still there, but it interacts with the gauge now, and remember, blocking works on magic attacks, so Spelltron, let's call it that now instead. Hallowed Ground is still there, and yes, it still sits on a 7-minute cooldown. Don't know that I entirely agree with that, but moving on. Circle of Scorn is still there, Bulwark is still there, Spirits Within is still there, but it no longer silences, we'll come back to that later. Tempered Will is there. I don't remember if this was on Tempered Will before, but it now cures Bind and Heavy effects as well as its old effect. I don't know if it did that before, but we've seen a lot of that being added into the game, so I figured I'd mention it here. Now, Cover is still there, but Paladin got a new trait for it. So whenever the Paladin covers an ally, the Paladin themselves also takes 20% reduced damage. And I'm not just saying like 20% less from the covered source. I mean, it basically is like whenever you use Cover, you're also getting the Rampart effect. Now let's go over some of the things that are gone, because Paladin had a lot of its inherent stuff moved into the cross-roll system. Rampart, Convalescence, Awareness, and Provoke are all in the cross-roll now and are not native to Gladiator or Paladin. Pretty much every trait that existed before has also been worked into their respective abilities or replaced with new traits. And keep in mind, due to the cross-roll changes, Paladins can no longer take actions like Stone Skin, Cure, or Protect. You're going to be strictly looking at the tank cross-roll stuff. So what shiny new things does Paladin have? Well, the first one is their Oath Gauge. So Shield Oath and Sword Oath now have an Oath Gauge that activates when you're in either stance. Switching between Shield and Sword Oath will reduce the gauge by half. So if you have 60 Oath Gauge and you're in Shield Oath and then you switch to Sword Oath, you'll only have 30 gauge when you get there. In terms of generating Oath Gauge, when you're in Sword Oath, you generate it based on how many auto attacks you do. So for every auto attack, you're generating Oath Gauge. When you're in Shield Oath, it's every time you block, which I'm wondering, I can imagine like on a big pull how much that means you get, and that's pretty crazy. But I think on single target bosses, I wonder if the generation is going to be fast enough in actual raid content. So what can you use this Oath Gauge on? Well, Sheltron we mentioned earlier, that one uses 50 gauge, but it sits on a much shorter cooldown, so it's really only gated by gauge now because the cooldown is so short. They also have another new skill called Intervention. This allows you to target a party member and give them a 10% less damage buff, so they'll take 10% less damage for about 6 seconds. It's got a super low cooldown of only 10 seconds, but it costs 50 gauge. Additionally, if you have Sentinel or Rampart active when you use Intervention, 50% of the damage production that's being provided by those buffs will also be given to the target that you give Intervention to. So let's say you have Sentinel up, which is 40% damage reduction on the Paladin, and you Intervention somebody. That person will have the 10% from Intervention, as well as the 20% from Sentinel. That's really all you can use your Oath Gauge on, are those options right there. Everything else has nothing to do with Oath Gauge, pretty much. They also got a nuke called Holy Spirit. It's basically an offensive alternative to Clemency. It's just a 430 potency nuke that uses a large portion of your MP. It does interrupt combos, so do not use it in the middle of a combo chain. You want to use it at the end and before beginning the next combo. It's worth remembering also, Fight or Flight only works on physical damage, so don't use it to try and buff Holy Spirit. Paladin's also got a new off-global cooldown skill called Requiescat. It's 350 potency, but its damage scales with your MP, so the lower your MP, the less damage it deals, the higher your MP, the more potency it has. Now, if you're above 80% MP when you use it, it also gives you a 20% buff to your attack magic and healing magic for 12 seconds. So it's best used before you're going to spam either Clemency or Holy Spirit in order to generate a lot of extra damage or healing. It sits on a minute cooldown, so I'd imagine you want to be looking at your MP just as it's about to be off cooldown and be like, you know what? I need more of that. And finally, we have Passage of Arms. This ability was also shown during the live letter number 36. It sits on a 2-minute cooldown, and it is a channeled skill. So if you move or try to execute another action, you're going to immediately cancel Passage of Arms. It raises your block rate to 100% for as long as it's channeled. Anyone standing in the cone behind the tank takes 15% less damage. So you can use it on big hits, you can use it for tank stacks for splitting damage between both the tanks, you know, have like the off-tank stand behind you while you're using this so you can mitigate a little bit more of that damage. It has a lot of applicable uses. I do have one curious thought, however. So another new change Yoshida mentioned regarding parrying and blocking was that you now no longer need to be looking at the enemy to parry or block. So I'm wondering, could you use Passage of Arms while looking away from the boss and then if the boss is small enough to like where the flank and the rear are still within that cone, can you look away from the boss and provide the damage mitigation to the people behind the boss? I really want to see if that works, so please try that when it comes out. Before we wrap up the video, let's go over the tank cross-roll abilities. As mentioned earlier, Rampart, Provoke, Convalescence, and Awareness are all cross-roll now, so if you want those skills, you'll have to grab them from the cross-roll. You also have Low Blow, which is an off-global cooldown stun with no potency, and Interject, which is an off-global cooldown silence with no potency. That's where the silence on your Spirits Within went, by the way. Anticipation is Dark Knight's old Dark Dance skill. That is now in the cross-roll, so if you want that 30% parry, there you go. There's a new skill called Ultimatum, which is an AoE provoke, if that ends up being necessary. I'm still thinking if they're going to make something like that more necessary for some of the upcoming content. There's also Reprisal. Now, that's Dark Knight's old damage reduction skill. It used to require you to land a parry, and then it did damage, and then it reduced the damage that the enemy dealt. It no longer requires parry, it's just an ability, and it simply reduces the damage dealt by the target by 10% for 5 seconds. It's basically a tank's equivalent to what Disable used to do. And the last one is Shirk, and this allows you to, and it says divert 25% of your enmity to another player. So I don't know if that means that, like, it's 25% of enmity you're about to generate. It doesn't have a duration, so I'm going to assume it's literally you just taking 25% of your enmity and giving it to somebody else. The biggest scenario I could imagine that being used for is something like a tank swap. So if you're having trouble with tank swaps, you'd use Shirk. Maybe you use it in order to like continue your combo. Like if you're in the middle of a DPS combo and you're about to have to do a tank swap, instead of stopping and going over to the other combo or needing to stop the flow and specifically prepare an enmity combo for the tank swap, you can use Shirk instead. But I don't know, I feel like people aren't gonna need this one as much unless there's like really good reasons in the upcoming fights to have something like that. So, what do I think of the Paladin changes? From the second I saw them shown to the second I saw the details for them, I love them. I feel like they got a ton of the quality of life updates they needed. The casting not being interrupted on both of their skills is big. They got a few more damaging tools, some of which they can spam in that of Holy Spirit. And they got the blocking, which now works on magical damage, which increases the value of block, which increases the value of Bulwark, of Sheltron, of Passage of Arms. All these skills they have that increase block are all super useful. The amount of damage mitigation they have seems to be like it's ridiculous compared to what the other tanks have. Yes, some of the skills are shared, like Rampart, but it's still like this insane amounts of mitigation with Divine Veil, Sheltron, just everything. Like I just told you everything. It's a lot of mitigation. The only thing is the content going to need that level of mitigation? Or is Paladin's mitigation just so over the top that people don't value it as much? I personally feel like having a Paladin would open up your raid to use some different things, because you don't need to stack as many mitigations, I'd imagine, when you have a Paladin. You could just go with a completely different composition that utilizes the fact that the Paladin is going to be responsible for protecting people. And you know what? That's the fantasy of a Paladin, your sword and board, but you are the main tank. That is what Paladins have always kind of envisioned, and that's what it seems like they're going for right here. We'll have to see how the new fights are designed, if Paladins can actually make full use of all these abilities, but I'm excited, I liked what I saw, and hopefully you did too. But anyway, that's going to be a wrap on my Paladin video. Be sure to like, favorite, subscribe, and share, and stay tuned, because we got a ton of other videos coming out. Anyway, thank you for watching, and until next time, take care.